was there a change of a referee and a judge at the last minute?
I really couldn't answer that because I don't know. I think you'd have to ask the Nevada Athletic Commission what this is. I mean, maybe a guy got sick or he had family obligations. I have absolutely no information about it.
You have proven right about Teofimo versus Kambosos not being a big fight. Do you regret restructuring the contract for Teofimo Lopez because you see Triller forfeit the fight to the zone and lose a lot of money?
No, again, we offered and bid what we could afford. I mean, you know, money isn't finite. You have to have budgets and you have to evaluate fights and determine how much you could spend on a fight. We did that, and Triller won the bid, and I think Matchroom was second. So, you know, we bid what we thought the fight was worth and what we could afford. But there is no animosity between us and the Lopez people. After we lost that bid, we sat down with the Lopez people and worked out a new contract with them going forward after the Kambosos fight, and I think everybody is pleased with the new contract.
Do you think Teofimo Lopez learned his lesson for colluding behind you to make the fight?
Well, I don't use the word colluding. I mean, when he knew how much we were willing to spend on the fight, and he didn't feel that it was adequate for him, his people went out and looked for companies that would put a higher bid in and get the fight. But the problem was in having Triller come with this really tremendous bid. The guy says, wow, I'm going to get $4 million for the fight because they bid $6 million. Or a little over $6 million, but they had no experience doing a big fight. They didn't know what they were doing. That's not a knock on them. And what we're going to try to do is to get these organizations to pass a rule to say that the only companies that can bid on a purse bid are those registered with the organization who have promoted at least one championship fight for the organization. You can't have somebody come in, well-meaning or not, I'm assuming well-meaning, and plunk down a few dollars and say, well, I'm a promoter and therefore I can bid with no experience of having done a world title fight or any fight. I mean, that was, everybody looks from the outside and thinks how easy it is. They don't know what has to go into it, the preparation, how much research you have to do before you pick a date, before you pick a site. They don't know that. That comes with experience. Now that they have forfeited Triller, they're out of the picture, and now the fight goes to Eddie Hearn's Matchroom. And Eddie Hearn's a real promoter. So people say, what do you think about Eddie Hearn getting and doing the fight? I say, that's great, because you know there'll be a bona fide, real promotion from Eddie, and we'll finally get that fight on, and then I can go and do what I have to do in the future with Teofimo.
Bob, if Teofimo were to lose and Kambosos were to win that fight, does that change his deal with you guys going forward?
No, because the deal contemplates a possibility of losing. But he has as much chance to lose to Kambosos as I do to knock out Tyson Fury.
Now, Bob, I want to ask you this. Teofimo told me last night that Devin Haney and his dad had a meeting with you and they never showed.
That is correct.
What happened there?
Devin Haney's father talked to Derek, who works for the company, mm-hmm. Derek Harmon.
He's right behind you, Derek.
Yeah, and they arranged to come in to see me,
uh-huh.
and he never did.
And that was for a fight with Teofimo, I would assume, or
well,
Noma?
A big fight, you know, whatever it was. Obviously, it wasn't necessarily only a fight with Teofimo, because Teofimo had an obligation to fight Kambosa. But we have a lot of, you know, great talent in those divisions.
Now, speaking of talent, you guys do a great job at Top Rank, taking kids from zero to championship.
Right.
And how do you know when it's time to test them? Like, Efe Ajogba, it's a very tough fight with him with Frank Sanchez. How do you know it's the time right now?
I have matchmakers
mm-hmm.
that really have great eyes. That's why they are my matchmakers. They get paid a lot more than matchmakers from other companies because I respect their expertise. The credit does not belong to me in that regard. I will go out and make fights for them, but only if the matchmakers approve the type of fights I'm going to make.
Now, in a month from today, Canelo's fighting Caleb Plant. If he does win, what do you think about a fight with Canelo and Artur Bitterbaev, your 175 star?
Look, profession aside, boxing aside, I mean, the fact that I'm a promoter, I am a big admirer of Canelo Alvarez and Eddie Reynoso. If they asked me to arrange a fight with Bitterbaev has a tough fight with Marcus Brown coming up in December, I would be honored to do that. But it's up to them. In other words, I'm in contact fairly much with Eddie Reynoso.
Great guy.
Because he trains
Oscar.
One of my great fighters, Oscar Valdez, and they're nice people. And we'll see what we're going to see. But, you know, I'm not pushing a Bitterbaev fight. That's up to Eddie. Eddie's one of the best boxing people in the world.
Bob, with Fury saying he wants to come out Wilder, you know, kind of like a train going at him, is that maybe the best strategy? Because like you said, you got to take the weapon away from Wilder, but also the most dangerous?
If it's Fury's strategy, and who knows, if it is strategy, what he said his strategy was going into the second fight proved that it was his strategy. If that's his strategy, Fury and Sugar Hill know what the hell they're doing. A hell of a lot more than I do in the ring.
Did Big Baby Jared Anderson have anything with him sparring with FA to take that Sanchez fight? Because based on style and the size of it, it's a perfect...
I'm not sure. I know that James Prince is the manager of both guys.
Okay.
So I assume before James accepted the fight with Sanchez, he had those discussions with fighters who had trained with Effie.
Yeah, because when you said you had good matchmaking, that
my matchmakers like,
right, they probably saw that.
If they say it's a tough fight, very tough fight, but they like that fight.
Bob, exactly. What do you think of Gervonta Davis? He announced his fight yesterday with Rolando Romero. Rolies, I'm sure you're familiar with Roly.
I'm not.
He's from Vegas, a good personality.
He may be. I mean, maybe the loveliest guy in the world, but
he's a trash talker.
I never saw him fight.
He fought Jackson Martinez, the one that Richie Comey knocked out, and Jackson beat him right before Richie Comey fought him.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, that's what happened.
But what do you think about Gervonta Davis as a fighter?
I don't know very much about him. I think he's pretty good. I know Floyd is a good judge of talent, and he seems high on him. So I think he's a pretty good fighter. You know, how good he is, I don't know, really. I haven't followed him that much. But, he's clearly an elite fighter.
But assuming that Tyson gets his hand raised on Saturday, will y'all see Usyk sometime next year?
Well, I would like that. But again, Usyk has an obligation to give Joshua a rematch. But again, obligations, we can all sit down, which I would like. Usyk, Fury, should he win here Saturday, and Joshua, and work out maybe a better arrangement where Usyk fights Tyson and the winner fights Joshua.
So basically, you're not opposed to paying Joshua's 10%.
Samir Lozano in the casa.
Hey,
¿Cómo estás? ¿Feliz?
Yeah, muy bien.
Well, when I do my interview with Frank, I key for the interview. He's okay. After, yeah. Do you know Edgar Belanga?
Yes.
He's muy bien. Okay. Samir. When he's done with his interview, we'll talk. How are you feeling today? Good?
Good.
Feliz?
Good. Yes, feliz.
You know, they were... Peña, I was very surprised that Frank Sanchez and Efe Jugba were almost at the same height.
¿Qué opinas de que casi están del mismo tamaño de Efe y Frank?
Pues que es una pelea pues pareja. Los dos tienen buen récord y va a ser una buena pelea.
Same had almost the same record on boxing. It's going to be a tough fight, hard fight, but we can't prepare.
1 month from tonight, Canelo Alvarez plant. What do you think? You're smiling.
A un mes de Canelo plant, ¿qué es lo que tú ves?
Pues veo que Saúl está muy bien preparado. Está haciendo una buena preparación con Eddie y creo que va a ser una gran noche para el equipo.
They're doing a great the great camp. It's going to be a great they're doing great things with Eddie and Saúl. And hopefully it's going to come a win for this whole team.
What's your prediction? What's his prediction?
For which fight?
Both.
For the Frank?
Yes.
Probably a knockout on the late rounds.
What do you think? Prediction?
Creo que va a ser una buena pelea. Frank tiene buenos recursos, ha aprendido muchas cosas que le ha enseñado Eddie y creo que va a ser una buena pelea.
Eddie has shown a lot of new plan for Frank. It's going to be a good fight, a tough fight. We'll see on Saturday how it comes.
And what about Canelo plant prediction?
Canelo plant tu predicción.
Pues no sé, como Canelo dijo que en el 8. Esperemos que...
He said 8.
Canelo said that 8, so we hope that it comes.
What do you think, Carlos?
I'm going to bet on the under 10 rounds.
Under
that's,
10.
That's my prediction.
What's Canelo's secret of success? You know him for many, many years. What makes him so great? Is it God-given talent? Is it work ethic? Is it super intelligent?
Es la ética, es el talento nato, ¿qué es lo que tiene Saúl?
Es la disciplina. Pienso que Eddie es un entrenador muy disciplinado y es lo que les inculca a sus peleadores. Y más que nada eso lo que yo veo que ser constante en el gimnasio y ser disciplinado es la clave del éxito.
Discipline, constant discipline. Eddie is he tried to show that to every of to the fighters that he trained. Discipline, you know, like constant, you know, doing training camp and doing in the hours that you have to, you know. And I believe that's the main thing that they have.
By the way,
they connect.
I made a video of Andy Ruiz's new tattoo and YouTube took the video down.
Que tú hiciste el video de Andy Ruiz de cuando se tatuó.
No, yo no lo hice.
No, he didn't do it. He didn't do the video.
No, there's a tattoo of Andy Ruiz on his whole back and his lower back. You didn't see it?
Yeah, I saw it.
I'm saying YouTube took it down. Frank, aquí.
Que si tú le tomaste la foto a Andy.
So first of all, tell me, how was the face-off?
¿Cómo sentiste el cara y
Efe Jugba?
No, bien, ahí se vio todo. Estuvimos haciéndolo ahí bien. Pues ahí vi que hizo una como una murmaga, pues fue los nervios que lo atacaron. Sé que está un poco nervioso, pues nada, yo tengo confianza en mí y el sábado voy a demostrarlo que soy un campeón.
You saw everyone that he looks kind of nervous. He tried to do a feint to myself. I look pretty calm. I know that he's nervous. I can see it in his eyes. We did a good preparation in camp. So we'll see on Saturday.
He tried to do a Caleb Plant on you.
Trató de hacer un movimiento como Caleb Plant.
Sí, exactamente, pero esos son los nervios que lo atacan.
Those are the you know, he's nervous.
You know,
he's kind of nervous, and he Frank believes that he doesn't think that Frank can handle it, but now that he saw it, I believe that you know, he knows that it's a tough opponent and probably it's going to be beaten.
Frank, I thought the height would be much more, but you guys almost the same height.
Pensaban que la altura de él iba a ser mayor a la tuya, pero están del mismo tamaño.
No, no, no me iba mucho, no me iba mucho. Y pues yo digo que eso no tiene que ver nada. Pues. Aquí lo que hay, yo no lo voy a cagar exactamente. Aquí hay que saber pelear.
It's almost the same thing. He's not going to, you know, like... try to stand in front of him. We're just kind of, you know, take it to the ring and fight and box itself. So
you can stand along with Usyk, you have the best footwork in boxing. You have very good feet.
Stand right there.
Okay. Igual que Usyk, cree que él que tú tienes el mismo trabajo de piernas.
Sí, tengo buenos trabajos de pierna, buenos movimientos de pierna, sobre todo la velocidad y la explosividad que tengo, pues eso son cosas que lo va a frustrar a él. Y ahí cuando lo vea no quiere.
He knows because he has the good ring movement and you know foot movement because of the Cuban, you know, the
Cuban school, yeah.
Yeah, and that's how he's gonna, you know, take advantage of him.
What did you guys think of Usyk beating Joshua?
¿Qué opinas de que Usyk le ganó a Joshua?
Quizá fue una mala noche para este Joshua.
Yeah, he believes that it maybe was a bad night for Joshua. ¿Tú, Frank?
Bueno, no, Usyk le ganó bien convincentemente.
Usyk won that fight convincingly.
So after he knocks out Efe Jugba, who does he want next?
Después de que le ganes o noques a Efe, ¿qué es lo que quieres después?
Pues ya grandes peleas y título mundial. Yo estoy listo. Voy a demostrar el sábado que estoy listo y el sábado cuando gane.
He's ready for championship fights. You know, whatever comes, he will be ready.
I gotta ask you this: you sparred Canelo.
No, esta vez no.
Not this time.
No, not this time. I said in the past.
Pero has sparreado con él.
Sí, he sparreado con Canelo.
Now, if Canelo can hang out with you and you're a huge heavyweight, what chance do you give Caleb Plant?
If he was on the same weight as Saúl, or...
I'm saying Saúl could spar heavyweights. So what chance does he give Caleb Plant?
Si Saúl ha sparreado con como pesos pesados contigo como tú, ¿qué posibilidad le ves a Caleb Plant? Zero.
Zero?
Zero possibility.
Like in the movie Dumb and Dumber, yeah. It was 1%. What is it? Nothing. There is a chance. Zero. Nada?
No. Does he look at this like this fight is the fight that will launch him to the like the top guys in the division?
¿Te va a lanzar esta pelea? ¿Te va a lanzar a las grandes peleas?
Sí, esta pelea pienso que me va a poner en buena posición para la próxima pelea.
Yeah, he believes that this fight is going to be his step towards big fights coming in the future.
And Ajaba said that he thinks he's underestimating his boxing ability, but has he seen anything that shows he can box a little bit?
Efe dice que has menospreciado su boxeo. ¿Tú crees que él está diciendo algo o que vio algo en ti?
No, no estoy menospreciando su boxeo, si no estoy diciendo la verdad. No tiene nada, no le veo técnica de boxeo, lo único que tiene la pegada y la pegada solamente no se gana.
He's not, you know, not seeing anything boxing skills on him. He just sees the one shoe on him. He's just going to demonstrate on Saturday that he has more boxing skill than
so if he avoids the right hand, he basically wins easy.
Yeah.
Va a ser fácil si tú evites su derecho.
Sí, claro que sí.
Okay.
Last thing, what do you think of Wilder Fury?
Bueno, para mí va a ser buena pelea, la tengo 50-50, porque cualquier cosa puede pasar en esa pelea.
Anything can happen, 50-50. Anything can happen in the ring on Saturday because both of them are great fighters.
Muchas gracias. Messages de fanáticos de Cuba.
Mira a los fanáticos que me sigan. Y aquí estamos, vamos con todo, patria y vida.
There you have it, gracias. Team Frank Zage. Thank you, Zamir Lozano. Thank you, Carlos Peña in the house.
Gusto verte de nuevo.
Muchas gracias.
Gracias, Eli.
Oh, anytime, de nada. Hello, Brittany.
Hi, Eli.
Hello. There is Sam Watson, the man of the hour, too sweet to be sour with his sons, Brandon and Marcus. How you guys feeling?
Mike Tyson, yeah.
Yeah, your dad's a rock star in Los Angeles. What are we doing the documentary or the movie?
Later. Ellie got to be involved. I know that. Ellie, you the man, Ellie.
No, we got to.
EsNews.
Reporting. We got to do a movie about your life.
He said reporting.
I got to have a role, too.
Hey, that is Jake Paul's number one fan on the planet. He loves Jake Paul.
No, he said about Floyd.
I knew Floyd wasn't gonna knock
him out. He's the number one hater of Floyd.
Somebody put $60 million in your bank account, you better not knock him out. Yeah, you'll be silly to do that. You know, right. Money brings money.
Hey,
you know,
we're gonna make. I hope Wilder puts this guy to sleep 3-4 rounds. I hope.
Awesome. So you don't want to interview me, Ellie. Remember, you was wrong great. The last time when I gave you my prediction in the last.
You hate Wilder, right?
No, I don't hate Wilder. No, why would you say that? No, I do not hate Wilder. Why? They was calling me the Wilder hater because I was trying to enlighten and raise his eyebrow about being
serious.
You know, to become a better all-around boxer and fighter in the sport of boxing.
What's
going to
happen,
to be
this,
on that,
gonna happen this fight?
Oh, this is an excellent fight. It all depends on Deontay Wilder, what Wilder shows up. For 2 years, he's been dreaming his nightmare to get redemption and retribution, to get it back in blood, like he said. It's all up to him and Malik Scott. Are they going to pay their dues? Are they going to understand to be aggressive and dictate the narrative of the script? It's supposed to be the Wilder show this weekend. You can't get caught up in boxing and irky-jerky moves. This is a rhythm and soul food fest fight this weekend. You come straight ahead and go back, the line dance. This is how Wilder has to do, the line dance. Four with a double jab, right hand, step back. Four with a jab, right hand, step back. Slip your hand.
This is Teddy Atlas from South Carolina?
No, but I'm serious.
Toledo, sorry. Robert Easter Jr.
Yes, he's done it. Give a shout out to Bonnie Albert Bell, Antoine Jones, and the real baby Jared Anderson over there.
Before I forget, guys. What do you think, Tank and Rolly?
Oh, Rolly Roll and Tank. I got Javonte all day.
Javonte
Rolly
all
gonna
day?
Put up a good shot, but Javonte Davis gonna walk him down and knock him out. It's gonna be entertaining. I like the show, Rolly show.
Sam,
Rolly gonna put on the show.
You know Bob Arum, Hall of Fame promoter.
That's my brother. That's my brother.
He promoted
That's
everybody.
You're a part of the group, young man.
Yeah. What's the name of this title, Sam? Because I wouldn't be able to see myself on there, that line dance. That was beautiful. That was beautiful, wasn't it?
Hey, you know the odds?
It was. That's basic fundamentals.
The odds if you bet on Wilder to win.
This is Joe, what?
The odds. If you bet on Wilder, round one, 33-1. If you bet on round 12, 80-1.
Really?
So if you put like $2,000, it's $160,000 if it happens in a 12.
12th round knockout.
Yeah.
Wilder.
Yeah. 11th round is 70-1, and 10th round is 60-1.
Probably gonna go the distance again, like that first fight.
So a draw is 25-1 if you bet on a draw.
It's probably gonna go the distance.
No, just 25-1. So you win times 25.
Subconscious retreat against each other. If Wilder come out aggressive, Fury gonna get on the back foot, and then since it's so close by Vegas odds, they gonna probably make it a close decision because both of them.
I just said it's 80-1. That's not close.
81 knockout, but that's not going to happen. That's a fool's bet. That's a fool's bet. No, it's not going down.
Can't nobody can get knocked out?
Not in the 12th round. What did you say? 12?
I said round one is 33-1.
Oh, no, no, that ain't going to happen. Not like that.
Well, I hope it happens early.
They're going to miss shots. Plus, they're going to be missing shots, the nerves.
I know. I got to get back to work, but thank you so much for the insight. We'll talk soon.
F.A., when you got the call basically that Frank Sanchez wanted the fight, how did you take that? Was it like did you take maybe offense to it that someone's calling you out, or were you like, okay, good, a big name on a big opponent? Like, how did you receive that he was calling you out?
Well, I don't understand what he's saying in the press conference. I don't know what he said, but okay. What I care is it's myself. I have to believe myself. That's all I have to say, because he'd be talking like knockout power, I don't have skis. Okay, you see about that in the fight. But the thing is, I'm a big guy, you know, so I punch hard. It's not about power. I punch very hard. So that's all about.
When you kind of,
it's just fun. Right, I just want him to have fun, you know what I mean? It's not about aggressive. It's not about that. You just want to have fun. Just play together, you know. In the fight, then it's going to be a serious war.
Did he react to it at all? Did you see in his eyes? Did he react when
I don't care about that. Everybody's afraid of everybody. This is boxing. Everybody's scared of him. Right. Everybody's nervous. You know, it doesn't matter. Like, fighting in the ring, like, it's not nervous. Anybody that says it's not nervous, that's a lie. That's a lie, because this is boxing. You know, this is a blood sport. So they don't really care about, like, fighting each other. There's no pity on the boxing, you know what I mean? So I just want to make him have fun, because he's calling me out. This is for the opportunity, you know, so we are here now.
Being that, you know, you were with PBC, now you're with Top Rank, now he's with PBC. Does that add anything to this
no,
matter
no,
for
no,
you?
No, not at all. This is boxing, you know, so just like Usyk and Joshua. They have the same different promoter, you know. It's different, so it's not really like a big deal, you know. This boxing, you know, everybody, like when I was in BBC, I have to fight the BBC by fighters. Now I'm a top fighter, so I have to fight BBC fighters. So it's both sides. Mm.
Being in the gym with Tyson Fury, and sparring with him, what would you say was the hardest thing to get used to in the ring with him? What's like the hardest aspect to figure out?
You know, it's not a Tyson Fury is a top dog, you know. So it's the number one heavyweight champion, the number one WBC heavyweight champion. You know what I mean? So like I said before, when I sparred with Tyson Fury, it gave me a lot of experience, a lot of strategy, a lot of fancy accurate, all the stuff, you know. It makes me make comfortable to fight guys like that, you know. So it's going to push me to the next level.
How much confidence does that give you, being that he's the guy and you're in there, you know what I mean, sharing the ring with him? And I'm sure,
because, you know, the confidence that I have, just to believe yourself, that's all. Just believe yourself, just for free, you know. That's all about. It's not, there's nothing to be scared of, like, okay, like as if you become an heavyweight champion, it's confident, you know what I mean? So, just like I am too. Mm. It's a human being, I'm a human being. So it's not, nobody's a robot. So that's what it is.
So what are your predictions on Fury versus Wilder?
I can't hear you.
What are your predictions on Fury versus Wilder?
Who wins, Wilder, Fury?
Wilder, Fury?
Yeah.
Let the best man win.
The fans are the winners.
Let the best man win. Both guys are warriors.
How about Caleb Plant and Canelo Alvarez? What's your prediction on that?
Hmm?
Canelo Plant.
I like Canelo. I'm a huge fan of Canelo. You know, I've watched Canelo fight. It's incredible.
I got one more. That's Crawford and Crawford.
Porter.
And Porter.
Sean Porter, Terrence Crawford.
Porter and Crawford. Ooh, man, that fight is gonna be rough. It's gonna be a rough fight, you know. So I'm going for Crawford to win the fight.
You said Canelo, you like Canelo a lot. What did you take from Canelo and Plant's little,
I take Canelo.
Did you think of anything when they kind of pushed each other at the press conference? Did you take anything from that? Was there?
No, not really.
Sorry, why boxing? You could play basketball, you could play soccer, you could play anything. Why boxing?
Boxing is not like popular in Nigeria, you know. Soccer,
yes,
is very popular in Nigeria. So I play soccer not to come up. So I had a fight on the streets, going out with my friends. So this is what happened, you know. So the lady smashed water on my body. But that's not what the attention, but she smashed by mistake. So all she needs to do is just to apologize. We let it go. But she's been rude, talking trash, you know, because his boyfriend is a bodybuilder. He think I'm going to be scared. I was like, what? I said, okay, all you need to do is just apologize. Just look at my shirt, you know, I'm trying to go out, you know. So he tried to be rude, all that stuff. So it's annoyance. I hit the guy, which is the guy, I mean, the boyfriend, the lady's boyfriend. I hit him, he fell on the floor. So I was thinking he's dead. So I was scared. People around me were screaming like I've killed somebody, you know. So I was looking for water. I saw water and I picked the water. I poured the water on his face. Like, that's when it stood up. When it's about to stood up, and I walked away. So those two of my friends, they saw what happened. They told me to do boxing. So I started thinking about it. It took a while for me to switch from soccer to boxing.
Africa has a big history in boxing. Africa, a big history in boxing. Azuma Nelson, a lot of champions from Ghana, a lot of champions from Nigeria, a lot of fighters. It's popular. People love fighting. There's a little kid. Did you see him? 6 years old? From I think he's Ghana. Very good in the gym.
Ooh.
On the internet, I see boxing is popular.
Yeah,
so back home,
because UFC.
UFC?
UFC, yeah. You know, UFC make Nigeria boxing popular, you know.
How would you do with the UFC champion, the big guy?
You know, I've not met them before. I just talked to them on social media and all that stuff. So I'm so grateful for them.
How did your English get so good in 1 year? Because 1 year ago, it was English.
It's my girlfriend, you know. My girlfriend, the mother of my two kids, you know. She's been teaching me English and that stuff. When I came here, I didn't know how to speak. So now I'm getting better and better because I'm trying to go for English class. to make me speak more confident and to speak in the press conference. But I didn't really speak well because for Sanchez, I don't understand the English because the speaker was low. So I'm trying to make sure I understand with it, but I can't catch it. So that's what happened.
My last question. Here in Las Vegas, how many people think you are Deontay Wilder?
Well, I don't want people to say that because
no, this no,
is knockout power.
You know, no. In the street. Like in when the they street. See you, yeah, they say, oh, are you Wilder?
No, I'm not Wilder, but it happens.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying. It happens.
So somebody saw a lady, not today.
Yeah.
Back ago.
Uh-huh.
Years ago. So
yes.
Some lady, they came to me, lady and a guy. Am I Deontay Wilder because I used to plait my hair like Wilder, you know. You know, I used to plait the hair back. And the way I walk, they told me, am I Wilder? And I cannot take a picture with her. I said, I'm not Wilder. I'm just a fear jaguar. And I said, oh, really? And they still took a picture of me, you know, so.
It's good. Message to Frank Sanchez and if he's watching?
Well, and, you know, he needs to stay ready, man. He needs to stay ready, you know. So I've prepared for this fight all my life. I've been preparing, train hard from Houston, come to Las Vegas, fight a lot of big guys, all that stuff. They keep saying that I have a lot of power, punches, I punch hard, you know. He needs to stay ready, man.
So what do you have
thank
to say?
You.
What
thank
do you,
you
have
so
to
much.
Say to all your fans, man?
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.